In the beginning, when I created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was a formless void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, while the wind from myself swept over the face of water. And there was evening and morning the first day, and the dome separated the sky from the face. Then I said, let a man have a guitar. And a man got a guitar. And I heardest with my ear that it was good. And then I divided the wood from the tree and said, let there be fiddle. Then someone else gave it to a woman, and I said, shreddest thou the fiddle lick? And it was I who called the man with the guitar, Andrew. And it was I who called the woman with the fiddle, Julie. And the greatest bluegrass band in the history of history was formed. And I call it that band, the Machsellers.
Thank you. I think there's a couple upstairs too, if you can figure out how to get up there.
Woohoo!
But anyway, hey, thanks for coming. We're doing a couple of tunes from our first album here. That was the Beaver Dam Blues. And next, we're going to do a song I wrote called Meet Me in the City. And I was really into blues back in the day. And I was really into this guy named Junior Kimbrough. And he wrote a song called Meet Me in the City. And so I kind of ripped it off, essentially. That's 10 years ago.
Although the Machsellers were the greatest bluegrass band in the history of history, like so many others, they never found fame or fortune. Several years consisted of living out of their car, eating only peanut butter. That's a hard existence. But one night, while sleeping in their car and eating hot peanut butter, something came to them. They noticed headlights approaching them. Where do those headlights come from, you ask? Headlights of holiness and transfiguration. Headlights through the bleakness. headlights for a small regional band on a small regional tour, just trying to stick it out like the peanut butter stuck to their mouth. Those headlights had names. One even seemed to have a banjo, and his name was Matt Hawkins. Play it, boy, play it. Let's hear that banjo from everywhere. The other seemed to be a player on the bass from where he was standing. We saw his haunted face, and we knew it was Chris DeVictor. Together, the headlights said to their god, "Don't let the Machsellers die along that roadside. Let them live! 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 Let them live!" And live they did. Together with those holy headlights, the Machsellers recorded the seminal earth-breaking album of 2016, Songs We Made Up.
Take fewer showers and sing this
Thanks, yeah, we had a really good time doing this Songs We Made Up album with this band. How about these guys, Matt Hawkins and Chris? Among Julie and I, they became affectionately known as the Bearded Weirdos. And it's still true.
One day, whilst playing music together, Chris DeVictor reached towards Andrew, and Andrew accidentally cut Chris with his guitar pick. Soon the cut became infected, and the infection went straight to his heart, his brain, and his blood. And Chris died. He died most rapidly, most absolutely physically painfully, grunting the whole time, and groaning too, and bemoaning existence too. Yet soon, Chris's ghost rose from out his dead corpse. This is the specter of Chris DeVictor. Doomed for a certain term to walk the night, and by the day confined to try to get some sleep in a hot festival tent. Since the foul infection that ended him in his day out in nature with his friend has burnt and purged, pricketh and stingeth his life away. Oh, list, if thou didst ever Chris DeVictor love, recall and remember his most foul and unnatural murder. Murder most foul, as in the best it is. But this, most foul, strange, and done by a close friend, Andrew. That's right, I'm accusing you of murder here. How else could he die so quickly? Unless there was poison on that pig. What do you have to say for yourself, Andrew? Let me be in my explanation, though it may take a while. Playing in his band, his custom some evenings, even at a fancy show. Upon his fairly comfortable zone, thy Andrew sliceth, with instrument guitar pick in poison tipped, and then the fingerprint of Chris's finger did pour. The lecherous distillment, the poison, whose effect holds such enmity with blood of man, that swift as quicksilver, it courses through the natural gates and alleys of the body, and with sudden vigor doth posset and curd, like eager droppings into milk. Ghost-like milk. Chris is thinking and also blood. So he died all at once and immediately, saying almost no last words except for a fecal grunt and groan. Oh, horrible, horrible, most horrible! If thou hast anything like love and kindness in thee, let not the Warwick Theater be a hotbed for quick pick cuts that lead to deadly infection, nor a hotbed for friendship poison dip. Oh, but it's getting late. I need to go home and go to bed. Fare thee well at once. The glowworm shows the all-night jammers to at last be getting started, and the ineffectual fire finally begins to roar. Adieu, Machsellers. Remember the ghost of Chris DeVictor. Keep him always in your heart, as he keeps you in his. But alas, the Machsellers pretty much immediately forgot about Chris DeVictor. They got a new bass player, Betsey May, and they immediately went to outer space.
Blue astronauts, so far away. Missouri's wearing the old crown.
Well, I guess people die down there like they die up here.
As a doornail.
All right, well, let's do one about people dying.
Dancing in the kitchen, slowly moving our feet. Dancing in the troubles and strife. We'd always look back and laugh at that one special time when we were dancing in the kitchen, slowly moving our feet. Dancing in the kitchen, just my darling and me. Some days are sour, some days so sweet. The day that I treasure the most, you were dancing in the kitchen with me. Things got worse and better, and worse, and a little bit better again. Sometimes we go to a bar, like the Westport Saloon, and we dance with our friends. But no matter the band, even if it was Dusty Rust, or the drink so fine, even if it was Four Roses,
to create the Wishful Thinkers Hall of Fame.
They get back to Earth, and then they ask themselves, why the fuck did we fire the band? Fame. Yet they very swiftly hired a new band, Brandon Day and Brian McCarty. And they all construct the wishful thinker all the fame. They built it up brick by brick, piece by piece, sweat droplet by sweat droplet, grain by grain. Like hard-working citizens of our planet Earth. Once the Hall of Fame was constructed, they recorded an album. This gave them no Grammys, as they knew it wouldn't.
Space Rock said it.
Good luck back on Earth, Machsellers.
All right, see you later, reporter. Round of applause for Matt Wyman over there.
Leave all our worries from the wind behind us when the neons glow and then the sun.
Thank you.
The truth is that I let you down. I turned around and walked away. Yeah, the truth is that I let you down. I turned around and walked away.
Who was even using this microphone before? Let it be written in the great tomes to be written about the history of history of our era. That this that you've seen tonight is the official account of the first 10 years of the band, the Machsellers. Very few bands, very few people have endured a journey of 10 years slogging through the pain and turbulence, hardship, adversity, and death upon death. Bravo, Machsellers. Bravo. For even believing they could make it 10 years, the Machsellers themselves should be inducted into the Wishful Thinkers Hall of Fame. But all joking aside, it makes no difference what men think of the Machsellers. The Machsellers endure. As well ask men what they think of Stone. The Machsellers were always here. Before man was, the Machsellers waited for him. I would like to see anyone here who believes they've given their community more than the Machsellers have with these songs. For this is the way it was and will be. this way and not some other way. If someone here actually believes they've played music for longer than 10 years, if anyone thinks that 10 years could just go by in the blink of an eye, if anyone thinks they've endured more musical longevity and more stamina, then speak now or forever hold your tongue. How long have you been playing music again? Are you supposed to be here? Is Howard Iceberg here? No one told me what he looked like before the show. Are you Howard Iceberg?
No, you're not.
But you've played music for 50 years. Would you like to take over the stage then?
Ladies and gentlemen, Howard Iceberg.
Check, check. You ready to do this? No, I love it.
Oh, good.
Say, boy, he can't sing anymore. But those of you who have heard me know I never could. Well, that hasn't seemed to stop me yet. So. This first song is one of those Love is Blind songs. She got a bus full of kids and she liked to have some more. Soon I'll be perfect for me. Once I was bitten and twice I was shy. This time around it's mom and cherry pie. Soon I'll be perfect for me. And I say, hey, next month it's Passover and Easter too. And she say, oh, I just love coincidences, don't you? Yeah. You're the same astrological sign as me, myself. And I say, well, what are the chances of that? Maybe 1 in 12. She's my Eve, and I'm her Adam. Measles and mumps, we both already have them. So that she'd be perfect for me. This next one. till I die, will not forget her smile. When first we sat a while in a little Irish pub, and she spoke about her broken home, and I about my trial, and how those who hurt may be made whole by the majesty of love. For the futile search for a friendly church to occupy our waking, but none of these were taking us. We were not pure enough. Wherefore, poor in spirit, we did hear it in the morning waking, a single song heard, singing of the majesty of love.
Thank you.
'cause the liquor is my curse, and the music is my calling. The last time I had seen him was a dive down in the river. Looked like he'd really hit the skids. He was trading songs for beers, and one that I remember he called, "This one's for the kids." Trading songs for beers, and one that I remember, "This one's for the kids."
America shall cease.
stand up and salute anybody's flag when they're working on equality and peace.
Thank you.